Hello everyone and welcome back to Math and Maticians. Today we're looking at a different kind of amazing person, someone who found beauty and elegance not in nature, but in the world of mathematics. This is the story of James Ax, a man who, like a detective solving a mystery, used his amazing brain to understand the complicated world of money and markets. James Ax, a name everyone in academia and finance knows well, was a genius who mastered advanced mathematics before going to the exciting world of Wall Street. His journey took him to new places and his insights and accomplishments changed how the world think about money. Our story starts in Spokane, Washington, where James Ax was born in 1937. Spokane, a city known for its beautiful landscapes and vibrant community, was the perfect backdrop for the early life of a budding genius. The city, with its rich history and culture, provided a nurturing environment for young James to explore his interests and talents. Even as a kid, it was clear Ax was very smart. His teachers often remarked on his exceptional ability to grasp complex concepts quickly. He wasn't just a quick learner, he had a natural curiosity that drove him to dig deeper into subjects that fascinated him. Whether it was solving puzzles or understanding the mechanics of how things worked, young James was always eager to learn more. His parents saw how bright he was and helped him learn. They created a supportive and stimulating environment at home, encouraging him to ask questions and seek answers. Family discussions often revolved around interesting topics, sparking James's imagination and fueling his desire to learn. His dad, a math teacher, taught him about numbers, and his mum, a librarian, helped him love reading and exploring. His father's passion for mathematics was infectious, and he would often spend hours explaining mathematical concepts to James, who absorbed them like a sponge. Meanwhile, his librarian mother introduced him to the world of books, opening up new paths and ideas for him to explore. The library, with all its books, was like a safari for young James, each one a new adventure. He would spend countless hours wandering through the aisles, picking up books on a wide range of topics. From science and history to literature and art, James's thirst for knowledge knew no bounds. The library became his sanctuary, a place where he could lose himself in the pages of a book and let his imagination soar. He wasn't just good at math. He wanted to understand how it all worked. He would often spend hours working on complex problems, not satisfied until he had a deep understanding of the underlying principles. His approach to mathematics was not just about finding the right answers, but about understanding the beauty and elegance of the solutions. For James, mathematics was an art form, and he approached it with the same creativity and passion that an artist brings to their work. He believed that the best solutions were not just correct, but also elegant and simple, revealing the underlying beauty of the mathematical world. He was like an artist with numbers. His ability to visualize mathematical concepts and see the connections between different ideas set him apart from his peers. He had a unique way of looking at problems, often finding creative and innovative solutions that others had overlooked. His talent was evident from a very young age, winning numerous math competitions in school, and became famous for being a numerical prodigy. His talent did not go unnoticed, and he quickly gained a reputation as a mathematical prodigy. Teachers and students alike were amazed by his abilities, and he became a source of inspiration for many. He got his degree in mathematics from the Brooklyn Polytechnic University in 1959, with the highest honors possible. His time at the university was marked by academic excellence and a deepening passion for mathematics. He excelled in his studies, earning top grades and the admiration of his professors. He then went to the infamous University of California, Berkeley. Berkeley was known for its strong mathematics program and distinguished faculty, making it the perfect place for James to further his studies. The vibrant academic community and the stimulating intellectual environment at Berkeley provided him with the perfect platform to hone his skills and expand his knowledge. There, he studied with Alfred Tarski, an extremely prominent figure in the mathematics community, and Mercer was able to finish his PhD in just 2 years, which is simply remarkable. Tarski was a renowned mathematician, and studying under his guidance was a transformative experience for James. He thrived in the challenging academic environment, completing his PhD in record time and making significant contributions to the field of mathematics. His big project was about what we can and can't prove in math. This groundbreaking work explored the limits of mathematical proof and had a profound impact on the field. James's research opened up new avenues of inquiry and established him as a leading figure in the world of mathematics. Climbing the academic ladder is no easy feat. It requires dedication, passion, and an unyielding commitment to the pursuit of knowledge. James Axe quickly became very successful in university. His journey was marked by a series of impressive achievements that set him apart from his peers. In 1962, he started teaching at Cornell University, one of 8 prestigious Ivy League schools, currently boasting an alumni class of 64 Nobel Prize laureates, 4 Turing Award winners, and 1 Fields Medalist. Cornell, known for its rigorous academic standards and vibrant intellectual community, provided the perfect platform for James to showcase his talents. Everyone was absolutely amazed by this young man, who seemed to have an endless well of knowledge. This expansive knowledge and innovative approach to teaching left a lasting impression on both students and faculty alike. His classes were brilliant, full of exciting ideas. James had a unique ability to make complex mathematical concepts accessible and engaging, sparking a genuine interest in his students. He didn't just teach, he wanted his students to love math. He believed that fostering a passion for the subject was just as important as imparting knowledge. He also wrote important papers, discovering new things in maths. His research contributions were groundbreaking, earning him recognition and respect in the academic community. His work was so good, he became a top professor at Cornell very quickly. His rapid ascent was a testament to his exceptional abilities and relentless drive. But James Axe always wanted to do more. He was never content with resting on his laurels. He constantly sought new challenges and opportunities to expand his horizons. In 1969, he went to Stony Brook University and, along with Jim Simons, helped make their math department famous. His influence was instrumental in elevating the department's reputation on a national and international level. He also taught at other famous universities like Princeton and Stanford. At each institution, he left an indelible mark, inspiring countless students and colleagues with his brilliance and dedication. James Axe's work didn't just have a small impact on the world of math, it changed math in a very big way. One of his biggest achievements was something called the Axe-Cochen theorem. This theorem, made with Simon Cochen, showed how different parts of math are connected. He also solved very old math problems. His work was like discovering new lands in math. He could also explain difficult math to everyone, not just other mathematicians. Just like nature has its best animals, math has its best people as well. And James Axe was one of them. Throughout his career, he was able to amass lots of awards. In 1967, he won the Cole Prize in Algebra, a very important prize in mathematics community. He also joined the American Academy of Arts and Sciences, a group of very important people that honors excellence and leadership in numerous fields. In 1972, he got a Guggenheim Fellowship, a special award for individuals who have demonstrated exceptional creative ability in the arts and exhibit great promise for their future endeavors. The journey from the abstract world of mathematics to the tangible, high-stakes arena of finance is a fascinating one. It's a story of curiosity, innovation, and the relentless pursuit of understanding patterns that govern both numbers and markets. James Axe's life changed dramatically in the mid-1970s. A brilliant mathematician, Axe was known for his work in algebra and number theory, but it was during this period that he began to see the potential for applying mathematical principles to the financial markets. Like an explorer finding a hidden valley, he discovered the world of finance, which seemed very different from the world of pure mathematics. The financial markets were chaotic and unpredictable, but Axe saw them as a new kind of puzzle, one that could be deciphered with the right tools and insights. This intellectual adventure began at Stony Brook University, a place known for fostering innovative thinking. It was here that Axe's path crossed with another brilliant mind, Jim Simons. Jim Simons, a fellow mathematician, shared Axe's fascination with patterns. Simons had a keen interest in applying mathematical models to real-world problems, and the financial markets presented a perfect challenge. Simons envisioned using these mathematical patterns to make money. He believed that the seemingly random movements of the market could be predicted and exploited for profit. Together, Axe and Simons embarked on a mission to see how mathematics could help them predict the market. They delved into data analysis, looking for patterns and trends that could give them an edge. Axe, with his exceptional mathematical skills, saw the market as a complex puzzle waiting to be solved. He was convinced that with the right approach, they could unlock the secrets of the market and make clever trades. They believed that by applying rigorous mathematical analysis, they could identify profitable opportunities that others might miss. In 1978, they took a bold step and started a company called Axcom Trading Advisors. This was not just another Wall Street firm. It was a groundbreaking venture that combined the precision of mathematics with the dynamism of the financial markets. Axcom was unique. It wasn't a typical Wall Street company. It was filled with mathematicians and computer experts who were passionate about using their skills to revolutionize trading. Axcom, with the combined genius of Axe and Simons, later evolved into Renaissance Technologies, one of the most successful and innovative companies in the financial world. Their journey from academic theory to financial success is a testament to the power of interdisciplinary thinking and the endless possibilities that arise when brilliant minds collaborate. James Axe didn't just visit the world of finance, he changed it. He started a new way of thinking, using computers and math to make decisions about money. Axe showed everyone that university maths could be used to make money. He used really complicated maths to understand the market. He found patterns that no one else saw. He helped invent new ways to trade, changing how the markets work today. James Axe's legacy is more than just the money he helped make. He changed math and finance forever, inspiring countless people from all different fields. He showed that math was not just studied in university, it can solve real problems and make very real money. He inspired other mathematicians to work in finance, showing them that their skills are important and the monetary compensation is astronomical comparative to academia. He helped create a new kind of trader, the quant, who uses math and computers to optimize decision-making. His work at Renaissance Technologies, especially with the Medallion Fund, made him famous in the world of investing. James Axe's story shows how powerful our minds can truly be. He was a true innovator who changed how we think about university and finance. He showed the world that math isn't boring. It's a powerful tool that can help us understand the world. James Axe, the math genius who changed finance, is one of the most important people we'll talk about in our series about the greatest mathematicians and traders. Thanks again for tuning in. Please like, comment, and subscribe to stay up to date on all things mathematical and financial. Until next time, stay calculating, my friends.